most of the talking. Amen? And the question is, why? Well, we're going to find in just a few minutes that the Lord had something that he needed for us to know. And that is, the Lord always warns us. He always gives us a word. He is constantly making and giving us instructions. This is about 13 chapters before he's literally entering his death march. The 12th chapter, as you read it in your own quiet time, will tell you that they had already gotten rebellious. They had already gotten to the point of saying, I'm going to get you. They had already gotten to the point of malice aforethought. Have I got a witness? And that is, don't let anyone tell you, but the murder of Jesus Christ was murder in the first degree. It was, in fact, premeditated. They thought about it. They schemed to get rid of it. Have I got a witness? They were just waiting on you and me and church folk in general to join that threat. So, in the 13th chapter, even at the first verse, he knows that he's got enemies in the court. So we're starting this morning, as the text readers, Sister Genesis started it all, saying that anyone that has ears, let him hear. And I thought that was, in my unbeliever state, kind of strange. The Lord created all of us with ears. And even though one of mine does not operate all the time, I still know that I've got. Amen. I'm just so impressed and with our minister who's visiting with us this morning, and with what he said about not going to the park, but coming to the holy place. Yes, sir. Because you know Mickey's nothing but a big rat. I don't care how you cut it. Amen. I'm not going to call on him. Now, I may go see him this afternoon or tomorrow, but this morning I'm going to be in the house. Have I got a witness? If there were rats in my house, my wife would be up on the counter. And we'll miss church to go see a big rat. Have I got a witness? By the way, I'd be up on the counter with her. Because I don't want her to fall. So what is there that the Lord wants us to have to take home so that we will be in a favorable position for blessings? So the subject for today is the Lord's message. That is the one that includes all of our words, his instructions, his warnings. Is it coming through? to you. I need two more amens. I'm asking, Brother Nolan, Brother and Sister Webb, glad to see you. Is the Lord's message coming through? I know the pastors and preachers in Memphis, Tennessee, and all over Florida and all over the United States is preaching and telling the Lord's message and doing what he has asked us to do. But I've stopped for a moment to ask the question, is his message coming through? Have I got a witness? Don't fool me now. Do you come in the door and sit in a ceremonial fashion and on cue clap your hands and even do a little dance and walk out without the message getting in a position to transform your life and my life? Have I got a witness? So with that, I want to talk with you concerning one word in the text for now, and that is parables. Amen? The original Greek word is parabolo. Parabolo, which says that the Lord taught and preached as he gave parables. His parabolical presentations were always, listen to me closely, difficult, obscure, and extremely hard to understand. There are 18 verses that have to do with parables just in the 13th chapter of Matthew. Have we got a witness? Well, if that doesn't alarm you, can I ask one other question? Why all of a sudden, and his disciples asked this question, why is it that Jesus has started to teach in parables, using parables? Have we got a witness? Why is it that you've changed your presentation? Have we got a witness? I've had people say, Pastor, you were doing all right as long as you were talking to us, but you start celebrating. Is it, why do you have to celebrate? Why do you have to preach and maul? Why don't you just kind of tell us like it is and we'll just take it the way it comes? Have we got a witness? And so you can see that you, if you had those kind of inclinations and concerns, you can see that the disciples had it long before you did. They wanted to know, and the verse will tell you after the ninth verse, is that they came to him and said, now wait a minute, we've been following you, but we've got a question of you, and that question is, why are you talking to them in parables? And why have you chosen to use parabola for these? And Lord have mercy. The answer is right there in front of us. Because the Lord said is, I've got to make sure some translations will say mysteries. Well, the issue is it's not mysteries in the classical sense. It is the gospel truth. Have we got a witness? That is, the Lord wants us to have the gospel truth when we, in fact, walk with Him. Have I got a witness? Now, I don't want, and correct me by raising your hand, I don't want to be left out if the Lord is giving instructions.
Is to attend
we see paramedics. Have we got witness? My wife got out of the car the other night and my cousins, and immediately they looked for a parasol. And if you look at Jesus and his method of teaching as a parable, or parable, is that you will see that he was using a earthly saying that had a heavenly meaning. Do I have anybody this who knows what I just said? Without God telling
you. Amen.
You have to be told. You have to be shown. Because even if you're sitting out here and today it's sunshiny and your peripheral vision as well as your direct vision will allow you 22.8 miles, it's not good enough. You still can't see what's coming around. You know what this message has taught me, this scripture, is that people can be sitting here looking straight in my mouth. And I would be reading the words like those text readers.